George Hospital. Fuck that joint.
Oh yeah. Fuck. You lived there for how long were you there? A week?
Fuck. 4 days, 5 days. What a cunt of a place. Fuck. Man, that was a... I'm thinking back now, I'm thinking, I don't know how it lasted, mate. It's a hospital. People are going to go in there, and there's so many people in there, and they're all sick. You know what I mean? You can't expect it to be a motel. You know what I mean? It's going to be people fucking screaming. Of course, it's a hospital. Fuck. But you just don't realise it. You think, fuck, everyone goes in there. You should be quiet. But it's not a place for people to be quiet because they're sick, yeah?
when I was in hospital after I had my stroke, every day, because... Your brain turns around, and I didn't know which way was up or down or anything like that. But one day, I was back at school, you know, in the centre where we had all the science labs there, and it was like a three-story place. Remember
that? Yeah.
And I was in there, and lunch was outside. And I was like, why is lunch outside? Well, I can't wait for lunch, you know. And then I'm thinking, why at school and these places I went to had arguments with my ex-wife where she wanted me to say yes and I would just say no. I'm all against anybody tells me something, I'll say no straight to it, no matter what it is. And I'm saying no, 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 no. Oh, other times, I get these triggers of the memories that just come back when I didn't know what the fuck was going on. Time, but I can't remember people screaming. I remember trying to get people to come out with me because I just wanted to escape.
Get going. It's getting cold out here, mate.
It is. Wind's picking up.
Yeah, it is.
I need you to help me push her out.
You want me on first or you want to
go? Just give it a push out. Let's go.